what to make out of the fact that it's a civil suit, Michael. What differences can you draw here that makes this unique?
Yeah, so not to claim it's that important, but it certainly minimizes the seriousness of it because of the fact that it's not based on a criminal complaint. There's no sworn testimony that this happened. The police haven't, as far as we know, investigated and reached any conclusions. A civil lawsuit in a worst-case scenario leads to the person who loses paying the other side money. It's not as grave of a matter as would be a criminal complaint. And I'm sure Brown's lawyer will argue that the absence of a criminal component to this makes the claim less reliable. And it puts Goodell in a position where he has to rely on a civil matter that normally wouldn't trigger that kind of, you know, punishment. On the other hand, look, Ezekiel Elliott wasn't charged or convicted, and he was punished for 6 games. Goodell hasn't always used the criminal process as a floor to decide whether or not to punish someone. So it's really up to him. My instinct, he's not always using a stick. My instinct is that he's going to be patient with this. He's going to not rush to judgment because we know so little at this point.
Well, and I mentioned earlier in the show, I mean, the only, I guess, similar comparison we could see in the world of sports recently, Derrick Rose was the subject of a civil suit for sexual assault that was filed in August of 2015. And it took well over a year for the trial to take place and for him to be found not liable when it was all said and done. So this could take well over a year to play out, Michael. Is that fair to say?
Oh, yeah. Especially if Brown countersues what the claims might happen. Now, I don't know if that's going to happen because that expands the scope of pretrial discovery. But this is not something that's going to get resolved overnight. It's not something that's going to get resolved. It's not unless they reach a deal in a court, which can always happen. The lawyers would say, let's strike a deal, let's end this. But assuming that doesn't happen, yeah, this is going to take a while. This will take months. I don't want to say it's going to go through the entire season, but that wouldn't be surprising if that's the case. So I don't think Goodell is going to be able to rely on really a full scope of evidence and testimony. He's going to have to make a decision based on what he knows. And the NBA with Derrick Rose waited out. Of course, he was found not liable in the civil case, and he wasn't charged with the crime. Maybe that happens here. We don't know.
And do you know about the lawyer for Antonio Brown, who has made the statement on his behalf and put forth a vigorous denial yesterday? Darren Heitner, who's known on his own website as the go-to lawyer for trademark filings and disputes. He obviously has some sports clientele for legal advice. Is Antonio going to get a criminal lawyer for something like this? I understand it's a civil suit, but how to square all of this, Michael?
Yeah, so out of disclosure, I met Darren back when he was in law school. I think he invited me when he was a law student to go speak down in Florida. And I met him there, and he clearly has gone on to a successful career as a sports attorney. You're right, criminal law is a different field. At this point, I imagine he's going to say that this remains a civil matter, that it's not yet turned into a criminal issue, that if it does turn into a criminal issue, if the police start to investigate, if they start to ask questions, I imagine that a criminal defense attorney would be brought in because it's really, it's all separate field.
For more of The Rich Eisen Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV for free on BR Live or download The Rich Eisen Show app.